What's up, America? This is Maserati Santana, host of On the Rize Radio, telling you to stay tuned in to the only station giving you the double information and inspiration, WDRB Media, the voice of the community.
Let's go now. We on the rise now. What up, people? Y'all already know what time it is, man. We on the Rize Radio. You know what I mean? Every Wednesday, 10:30 a.m. Make sure y'all tapping in with that link, man. Hit the webpage, WDRB Media, man. You already know what time it is. Also, go find and go follow me right now, Mozzie Bracken 18 on Instagram. Also, don't forget about Facebook, Mozzie Roddy Santana. You know what I mean? We are the voice of the community, so we bringing you double the exposure, double the inspiration and information. You can't lose with being on this platform. You know what I mean? But we got a dope show for you this morning, man. We got another special guest in the hot seat. So y'all make sure y'all sharing this live right now. The special guest that we got in the building, I'm not going to introduce him. I'm going to let him introduce himself. Who we got in the hot seat with us?
Hey, what's popping, y'all? My name is Diedrich. Follow me on IG, _DEADRICK_. Let's go.
How you feeling today, brother?
Man, I'm feeling good, man. I feel really good. I'm just glad to be alive and able to be blessed with the opportunity to be on this show, man.
Absolutely, man. I'm you know, I appreciate you for being on this platform. You know, we had you on the Rize TV. Now, what do you know? You back on the Rize Radio. You get double the exposure.
Hey, that's, you know, lit.
Absolutely, man. So for the people that don't know who Diedrich is, go ahead and let the people know where you from, man, and a little bit about what you do.
Hey, what's going on, y'all? My name is Diedrich. I am from Silsby, Texas. We call it Smoke Town, but I'm just a Texas artist. And what I do, I make music, I engineer, I also shoot music videos as well.
So you do it all then?
Basically.
That's what's up. Just like, well, how long have you been doing videography?
I'm not even gonna lie to you. I really just started to get into videography. Like, I've been researching the game, like Adobe Premiere Pro, and utilizing all the services or whatever sources I can use to learn from it and then apply it to myself to make it a skill set.
Absolutely. And how long you been
rapping? I've been rapping for like since I was in like fifth grade. I learned I had a talent for it. Like, I started writing poems first, but then I started to flow it with music and stuff. But what really like solidified me knowing that I had the talent to like make music and put words together to make it like rhyme and all that stuff was when I was in the eighth grade. We had like a little science project or something like that. We had to talk about protons, neutrons, and electrons. And I had like the Weeby Steady Mob and beat by Lil Wayne in my head. And I just like started going with that. And it was kind of dope. I was like, dang, I didn't know he could rhyme like that, cuz. Like, my classmate was like, dang.
Right. That was like a tongue twister, what you just said right there.
Yeah.
But you know what? The good thing about it is it allowed you to be who you are now.
Facts.
And not only that, you are in the military.
Yeah.
What branch are you in?
U.S. Army.
Oh, man. How's it feel being in the Army?
It's a good experience. It's a good stepping stone. But what I will say, that although it is a very great experience to like join and stuff, I won't like, because some people do get drained out from like doing, because it's a lot of things we sacrifice. Shout out to all my battle buddies and all that stuff. But it's a lot of things that we sacrifice to make things work and how we serve and protect the country.
Facts. And how do you serve and protect the country? Like what made you even want to get into being in the military?
What made me want to get into the military? I just wanted to get away from home. And I just felt like I had no other way out, because, I mean, yeah, I was good in school. And yeah, I did go to college, but certain things happened to me that made me, hey, I need to make something work and I need to do something. And the military was the way out. So I hit up my old recruiter, and like, well, he wasn't my old recruiter, but I knew he gave me his information. Like, when we was in high school at one point in time, when they had like an orientation or whatever.
Facts.
And then he just gave me his card and I just hit him up, and he hooked me up. And I left like the next 2 weeks. Like, cause yeah, if you join the Air Force or whatever, you ain't leaving till like maybe like a year, 2 years later or whatever. But no shout out to y'all. Shout out to Air Force. But I'll say it was an overall great experience.
Let's talk about how different the two platforms are though, on the Rize TV and on the Rize Radio. What do you see that's different?
On the Rize TV, I don't know, cause like the thing is, it's like, the chemistry, both of them have really good chemistry, and I'm able to vibe with it both. But for me personally, what's different, I don't know, because like, it's good chemistry on both. But the radios, it's just like, it feels much bigger on the radio than it is on the TV, because like, I know we'd be on IG Live and there'd be a lot of people tuning in and all that stuff.
Right.
But like on the radio, it's like, I feel like it's like even like on a bigger scale.
Absolutely.
Like, I don't know, it's because like, you never know who's really listening or tuning in right now. Absolutely. But it's like, it's pretty big. It's a big difference, but the thing is, the difference, I don't know the difference, because it's like, to me, I feel the energy in both, and I feel like it has really good chemistry. Only thing difference is like, which one's bigger and which one's not.
With streaming on all these different platforms, you know what I'm saying? And you just don't want to just be tied down to one.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So both of these platforms are really big. I would say the difference is you can't see the artist perform.
I would say this. I feel very welcomed. I'm not even going to lie to you. I just love the energy.
Absolutely. I appreciate it, man. So let's talk about, when did you get started with music? And what was the motivation, man, to like, you know, I can do music?
Let me tell you, it's a good story behind this. All right, so in Texas, there's this place called Anahuac, Texas, and they have a thing every year called a Gator Fest. I was in the Army Reserve at this time, and like the thing with this is like, what came to me, like, actually, like, getting into a real live studio, getting my stuff mixed and mastered. Shout out to my boy Locos Dollars, because he the one that like mixed and mastered and engineered and produced the stuff. But what led to that happening was, like, during the Gator Fest and stuff like that, like, one of my homeboys was talking to this girl. The girl was with somebody else already, but she was telling everybody they broke up. And I was like, oh, I don't care. And then I don't know why he still told me to, like, hook me up with her, up with her and stuff like that, even though he was already in the door. So I was like, I mean, I guess, or whatever. So, like, it led to me going on Twitter. And I slid in her DMs and stuff. I said, hey, my homeboy, I want to talk to you and stuff like that. You know, just put in a good word and all that stuff. And, like, what happened with that was the dude that she say she broke up with hit me up. Like, he didn't hit me up, but he screenshotted my stuff and then kind of blasted me on Twitter and stuff like that. And then, like, I was like, dang, why would you do that? I thought y'all was single. Like, y'all thought y'all broke up and all that stuff. But, turns out that they didn't, and she was just selling, like, my homeboy a dream and stuff like that. I don't know what they did. I don't care, because it's not my business. Right. But whenever is this guy on Twitter who's always been trying to, bully me and stuff. Like, he always had something slick to say, and I was like, why are you always trying to come at me and stuff like that?
Facts.
But I don't know what the relationship is now. Shout out to him. But I don't know the relationship between me and him. I have no ill will towards him or nothing like that. But, hey, things happen in the past. It is what it is. But that, doing that stuff, like, when he was, like, trying to bully me on Twitter and trying to make it seem like, oh, yo, I'm on you and stuff like that, and throwing all types of salt on my name and all that stuff. So they let me go to the studio, like, 2:00 in the morning, hit up my boy Locos Dollars, do this song. It was to that back-to-back Drake beat.
Okay.
And, like, it was, and that's when back-to-back was, like, really, like, going. That's
yeah,
why
Meek was popping.
Meek was, like, taking that L. Shout out to Meek. No disrespect. But, when he did that, I dropped it like 4:00 in the morning. All of a sudden, my Twitter was blowing up like crazy, like saying, dang, you the GOAT and stuff like that. And they were saying all types of stuff. I said, hey, man, you got to respond, because it was a diss track. But he said, hey, man, you got to respond real talk. But the thing is, it wasn't like it was a diss track, but it was nothing but facts, though. That's the funny thing. It was like, it's nothing but facts. And I was serious. And I was like, when I seen like how many people like was like validating all like that song and stuff like that, and then quoting the lyrics too, it made me realize that, hey, I actually do got something with music. And then I put out another song the next day called Tongue Twister.
So, like, so here's a question for you, for all the non-Twitter users. How do you use, what is the correct procedure of using Twitter?
See, that's where I think marketing comes into place. Technically, because I'm, like, I don't know how to use Twitter now, because I barely even use Twitter now. I be on Instagram and TikTok. But Twitter, I think you just, besides tweet, you just share, you quote, you like DM other people if you're trying to like do collaborations. Kind of like how IG work, instead of like with pictures, you can, even though you can't put pictures on Twitter, you just tweet and just connect with others.
What is your number one platform for social media?
Instagram. Follow me, by the way, _DEADRICK_.
So the best part about being into this music industry for Deidrick would be what?
The best part is the fact that I still own my, it's my like the ability to like be able to create, and the ability to go in the studio and display how I feel into the microphone. Whatever beat that's on right now, I'm able to feel it, and I'm able to do exactly what I need or what I feel or what I please with that. And that's what makes me feel fulfilling by doing this. It's fulfilling because I have the right, or I have the ability to like freely express myself.
So just being independent.
Yeah, basically.
You know, and what kind of advice do you have for all those artists out there that's getting themselves tied into the wrong deals, signing paperwork without looking at the fine print? Do you have any words of wisdom for them?
Get a lawyer. Get a lawyer and read the fine print. Please read the fine print. But if you can read it and you can't understand certain terms, please have a lawyer to like consultate with you and all that stuff, so you can like, they can explain exactly what this means, what this terms mean, or whatever, so you can better understand what you're getting yourself into.
So, like, did you ever start off with a group, or you just came into this industry alone?
I came alone. I always been.
You never been with a group before?
I mean, I rapped with people before, like featured with a couple of artists, but I never been with a group before.
Okay.
Ever.
All right. So, with the different type of features that you had, was these features competitive? Was okay? Like, did you have that certain vibe with certain artists where you didn't have to compete with?
I don't like to compete. I mean, I like to compete, but I don't like, I never felt like I had to compete, but I do love to compete with other artists, like saying, hey, my verse better than yours. Like that, we comparing verses and stuff like that, which one's harder and stuff like that. But I actually like that because I feel like it pushes us better. It pushes us to be better, like better artists like, as a whole.
Facts.
Because like, I'm not even gonna lie to you, because like the game, it's a competitive industry. Not even gonna lie to you. Like, but you gotta do what you need to do in order to be, I won't say like nothing crazy or nothing like that, but you gotta do what you gotta do to like get to that certain level where you're trying to go.
Absolutely.
And I feel like it's good to have competition, so your like have your peers as competition, so that you can make yourself better as an artist in the long run. Because either way it goes, like competition is supposed to make you better. If you ain't got no competition, you ain't doing nothing right.
That's a good answer. You're from Texas, man.
Very.
You know, what is there to do in Texas that on a, we'll say on a normal Saturday? I mean, what is there to do in Texas?
I mean, chill, go get some, in the summertime, go get some crawfish, have a crawfish boil or something like that. So, chill. But it's a lot of things in Texas that you can really do, especially like you want to go to Houston or stuff like that. You go out to eat, go to the club or something like that. It really doesn't totally matter, but it really is a lot to do in Texas, like a whole lot. You can go to Galveston, go to the beach or something.
So, like, what would you say, like, the biggest part of, like, doing music for you, what would that be?
The biggest part?
Yeah.
Just like I said that one time I won the Rize TV, it's like therapy to me. It's like it helps me cope and it helps me express myself. Because like again, like I said that one time, as a man in this world, you're like, and how we're socially conditioned, you're not able to like actually express yourself. And I speak for men who are not, feel like they don't have that way out and don't have that outlet to express their how they feel on the inside, because it's a lot of men going through things.
Exactly.
And they don't have a way to do that. They don't have a way to like just talk about it, because right now we're socially conditioned to be like, oh, you're a man, you're just solely a provider. We don't have feelings. That's what like the reality is kind of is right now.
I mean, everybody got feelings.
Exactly.
You know, and we need to start paying more homage to everyone's feelings.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I think we need to start practicing that in our daily agenda as well.
Yeah.
Let's talk about artist development for artists, for any entrepreneur. What type of gems that you dropping for the independent artists right here on this radio show?
Pay your producers. Make sure you do have a licenses to like the beats. Make sure you copyright your stuff. Oh, and a big one. Register your stuff through BMI and ASCAP, and get a song trust. Get a song trust.
Ooh, let's talk to them about the song trust.
Song trust is basically they help you calculate how many streams you're owed.
Ooh,
that's pretty much it. Like, cause normally like say like you with a distributor and stuff like that, like DistroKid or TuneCore and stuff like that, and like the sales have not been, they may not have been reported yet, and like you're looking at your bank statements through DistroKid and stuff, they might tell you like you're only entitled to this amount of money from the streams you got. But technically when you use Song Trust is there to like tell you exactly how much, like due to all the streams you got throughout all platforms you have.
Yeah.
And you it just basically tells you exactly how much you're entitled to.
Okay, that's dope right there. So I hope y'all taking a pen and paper,
please,
and I hope y'all dropping those gems down that Deidre just gave y'all. So make sure that you tapping in with Song Trust, man.
Yo.
Y'all want y'all money, right? I would think so. Alright, man, so you sent in a record. Let's briefly talk about that record before we play it.
Coney Island? Yeah. Heck yeah.
Alright, so What is the message behind that song?
The message behind it, the song is just basically talking about an experience that I had in Detroit. People think Coney Island, I'm talking about New York, but if you're from Detroit or you like you're in the Detroit area, you know what Coney Island is.
Shout it's basically out to Detroit.
Exactly. Shout out Detroit. But you like if you actually like went to Detroit, like you've been around, you know what Coney Island is. It's like a restaurant. It has really good food and I actually liked it. I was like, I'm trying to go out there soon, like really trying to get some Coney Island because I ain't gonna lie, I kinda miss it. But but I'm just basically like how the experience was, it just basically told me like, hey, look, just explain how you feel and just whatever you feel, let that out and just use that to not let you don't let yourself stay down from like external things that happens to you while you're going throughout your life on a day by day basis. But just vent it out and just do what you need to do to like get better and keep moving forward. I'm not even gonna lie to you. I made that song like in November. But I dropped it on all platforms in January.
Okay, first quarter.
And I leaked it in December. Yeah, I leaked it. I just said, man, this song is too hard. I got to put it out.
Wow. All right, man. Well, you know what? I like the message behind the song. And definitely shout out to Detroit. I'm a fan of Detroit, Michigan.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I got a lot of friends out there. So definitely shout out D-Town, especially Southwest.
Yep.
Go ahead and introduce that record, man. We're going to go ahead and get into it.
Oh, Coney Island. Hey, look, tune into Coney Island. It's on Apple Music, Spotify, any streaming platform you can think of. Just Coney Island, Deidrick, D-E-A-D-R-I-C-K, Coney Island, C-O-N-E-Y-I-S-L-A-N-D. Let's hear it.
Myself, I do it by my lonely. Do this by myself, I do it by my lonely. Gotta watch my back, cause all my eyes be on me. When I shoot, I never miss that beat like there go Kobe. Don't you say you love me, you gon' have to show me. She said she gon' turn me on PlayStation Sony. She gon' pull up to my crib and ride me like a pony. I don't like to kiss and tell, I just keep it low key. I'ma buy a private island and just name it Coney. Ay, yeah, Coney. All my brothers roll deep. Ay, yeah, moving fast, all of you just low speed. I don't quit, I dust myself off and I keep on going. She asked me why I eat so good. Girl, you taste like Coney's. Bitch, you're too easy. The way that I move slick is greasy. My flow is so sick that I'm wheezing. She offered me brain, come teach me. Give me the knowledge I needed. There for relieving, therapeutic. I'm catching the sleeping. Giving her back just so we are even. Don't you come back until you are needed. She constantly calling me toxic. I'm just a young for the slow. Look at my diamonds, they wet and they glow. Look at your diamonds, they need to get soaked. I'm walking the water, I'm pushing the boat. I'm kicking her out, don't mean it be cold. Blood is so cold that I got me a goat. You rappers can freestyle the shit that I wrote. You my son in the back that I told. They call me a star, they watching me go. It's not many pictures, they think I'm magnificent. Think I'm proficient, they call me the goat. Despite that I'm living, I bury my feelings. I hate when the ceiling, my heart, it be broke. A piece of me missing, I wish I could listen to whisper of words that come from my soul. Ay, do this by myself, I do it by my lonely. Gotta watch my back, cause all my eyes be on me. When I shoot, I never miss that beat like there go Kobe. Don't you say you love me, you gon' have to show me. She said she gon' turn me on PlayStation Sony. She gon' pull up to my crib and ride me like a pony. I don't like to kiss and tell, I just keep it low key. I'ma buy a private island and just name it Coney. Ay, yeah, Coney. All my brothers roll deep. Ay, yeah, moving fast, all of you just low speed. I don't quit, I dust myself off and I keep on going. She asked me why I eat so good, girl, you taste like Coney's.
Let me go speak in my soapbox. She's clean like she clove rocks. The way that she's, I'm changing her name. Peeping, poking my niggas be sleeping. Sleep on me harder than Snorlax. Until I drop, you say my nasty. Tell me it's nasty like coleslaw. My place is not vacant. Ain't no way that you can just replace me. She tell me she mine, but I know that she lying. I know that can't be taken. She be like, this you can save me. Can't be saving, man, just face it. I only just swim in your lake and I'm just gonna spend up my snake and you know I'm a thief and I'm snatching. Get say that I'm going with the break-ins. You so lame with the shades. Don't be hitting my line with the hate. They mad at me, want me, calling me master slave. Them ladies, they thirsty, actually hungry. They look at me like I'm a steak dish.
Do this by myself, I do it by my lonely. Gotta watch my back, cause all my eyes be on me. When I shoot, I never miss that beat like there go Kobe. Don't you say you love me, you gon' have to show me. She said she gon' turn me on PlayStation Sony. She gon' pull up to my crib and ride me like a pony. I don't like to kiss and tell, I just keep it low-key. I'ma buy a private island and just name it Coney. Ayy, yeah, Coney. All my brothers roadie. Ayy, yeah, moving fast, all of you just low speed. I don't quit, I dust myself off and I keep on going. She asked me why I eat so good, girl, you taste like Coney's.
Into it so you can actually get the vibe from it. But I do want to take the time out to, you know, acknowledge my sponsors. You know what I mean? Shout out to Unhumble Clothing, the Kid Day Uno. Shout out to him. Shout out to Mike Fight, Suge Diddy, the Infamous. You know what I mean? And shout out Beso Wellness from Los Angeles, California. She got those products for you. If you need a massage, if you need anything dealing with hair products, she got you. You know what I mean? So y'all make sure y'all tap into my sponsors. Jumping right back into it with you, DJ. What are some things that you have coming up for us in 2022?
I got music videos. I got a lot of things. I've also gotten into photography too, but it's a lot of music videos going on. I also got a song that's going to be, I'm releasing a song at least every month. Maybe one, two, maybe three songs, but you will get a song out of me every month. No lie. Like, I'm being really consistent with it. Until I see that specific audience that's tuning in, mm-hmm. I'll even drop an album. Because I have like a 24 song project right now, just ready to go, mixed and mastered, that nobody has even heard. And they're all dope, like crazy dope. Facts. That people will tune into. If I see a specific audience or a specific amount of people like tuning in and stuff, I'm gonna just drop it.
Absolutely.
I got a lot of things going behind that.
And see, that is smart marketing right there too. And I like the fact that you said as soon as you see the type of audience. And you know what? You have to be in conjunction with your audience.
Yes.
The people that you are putting this music out for, you want to make sure that they're tuning in to what you're doing. So a lot of artists get out here and they just make music. They just push out any promo they want to, but they don't really know their audience.
Mm-mm.
So how are you reaching your people?
How I'm reaching them?
I'm just saying, like, they don't reach their people.
Oh, yeah.
But how would you reach your people?
How?
Yeah.
Literally, I go out, or this is what I do. I literally run ads and stuff, and I see who's tuning into them. And the thing is, there's like a... nobody knows this. This is a thing. It's like a little smart tool or a smart URL. I won't say a smart URL, but it's like a tool you can use that can actually like display who these people are, where they are, what age they are, what websites they go to, and stuff like that. And I target people like that, and that's how I've been building my audience, just by targeting those same people.
Smart.
And also building like a new audience just by putting out like quality music each time, and just like putting it out. And sometimes people be talking about me, and people going in my Instagram and following me.
That's smart, man. You know, because you got a wave going.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And people see that, they want to tap into that. You know what I mean? I definitely commend you on that. You know, and you definitely been dropping gems, you know, this whole interview. You know what I mean? So I hope everybody that's tuned in with us has been listening to everything that you said, and you've been giving them words, encouragement of wisdom and everything, bro. So I salute you on that, and salute to Texas one more time. We out here in Fayetteville, North Carolina, and you know what I mean? Stand up for the 2-6 and for the 2-5. You know what the time it is. I also want to say, here at WDRB Media, iHeartRadio, we give you double information and inspiration. So we like to inspire, you know, independent artists, you know, and we inspire major artists as well. You know what I mean? To keep pushing, keep doing your thing. I want to know, do you have any last words for your fan base, your audience, your family, your friends?
All I'm going to say is, hey, look, don't give up. Keep doing what you're doing. You are enough. You just got to make sure, you got to keep convincing yourself that you are enough. You need to get up, go do what you need to do, breathe, pray, just do what you need to do to get where you need to go. But Believe in yourself. You can do it. Just don't give up.
That's right. Believe in yourself. You got to believe in yourself first before anybody else can believe in you.
Facts.
It start with you first, so make sure you're doing that. Any last shout outs?
Oh, shout out to Redden. Good dude. Great rapper. Shout out to Locos Dollars. Remember, I was just talking about him.
Mm-hmm.
Most of all, shout out to my mom. Shout out to my kids. Shout out to my BM, who's holding down the kids while I'm doing what I need to do and stuff. And I appreciate her for that. Oh, by the way, I'm about to buy your car, too. But,
okay.
But yeah, just shout out to all them.
That's what's up. Good things come to those who wait, man. You know, and big things come in small beginnings. You know, I'm speaking biblical terms to you now. You have to wait. Everything is done in the process. So you can't override the process. If you go to a new job, you got to go through orientation, right?
Yep.
Now, orientation is something like artist development.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I don't care how old you are, how big you are, and how long you've been in the industry. You have to go through the process of artist development, not only to learn the music, learn how to perform, learn the registry of dropping your music, but just learning the business side of the game.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So make sure we tapping into that with our everyday agendas. That's going to really wrap it up for today's interview, man. I like to thank my audience. They always a dope audience for me, even on the Rize TV. You know what I mean? You get double the exposure when you come up here, baby. On the Rize TV, on the Rize Radio. Make sure y'all tapping in with my Gmail, on the Rize TV at gmail.com. Go ahead and send them clean tracks to me, man. If they're not clean, I always say it on every interview, it's not going to get played here at WDRB Media, iHeartRadio, Tuned In, Sirius XM, Hip Hop Nation, all that. Your boy Mozzie, I'm on everything. Shout out to the Ville, the 2-6. Shout out to Music North County, segment. The 2-5. You already know what it is. And Diedrich, man, shout out to you for blessing a hot seat on this platform, bro. I appreciate having you here, man. And you already know what it is, man. We've been on the Rize Radio. Tune in every Wednesday, 10:30 a.m. Just hit that link, and you're going to get your boy Mozzie. I am your host. Salute, and I'm up out of here. Peace.
Yep, yep.
By myself, I do it by my lonely. Gotta watch my back, cause all my eyes be on me. When I shoot, I never miss that beat like Dirk go Kobe. Don't you say you love me, you gon' have to show me. She said she gon' turn me on PlayStation Sony. She gon' pull up to my crib and ride me like a pony. I don't like to kiss and tell, I just keep it low key. I'ma buy a private island and just name it Coney. Brothers roll deep, ay, yeah. Moving fast, all of you just low speed. I don't quit, I dust myself off and I keep on going. She asked me why I eat so good, girl, you taste like cronies. Bitch, you're too easy, the way that I move slick is greasy. My flow is so sick that I'm wheezing. She offered me brain, come teach me. Give me the knowledge I needed, there for relieving. Therapeutic, I'm catching the sleeping. Giving her back, just so we are even. Don't you come back until you are needed. She constantly calling me toxic. Just a young, for the slow. Look at my diamonds, they wet and they float. Look at your diamonds, they need to get soaked. I'm walking the water, I'm pushing the boat. I'm kicking her out, don't mean to be cold. Blood is so cold that I got me a goat. You rappers can't freestyle the shit that I wrote. You my son in the back that I told. They call me a star, they watching me go. It's not many pictures, they think I'm magnificent. Think I'm proficient, they call me the goat. Despite that I'm living, I bury my feelings. I hate when the ceiling, my heart, it be broke. A piece of me missing, I wish I could listen to whisper of words that come from my soul. Ay, do this by myself, I do it by my lonely. Gotta watch my back, cause all my eyes be on me. When I shoot, I never miss that beat like Dirk go Kobe. Don't you say you love me, you gon' have to show me. She said she gon' turn me on PlayStation Sony. She gon' pull up to my crib and ride me like a pony. I don't like to kiss and tell, I just keep it low key. I'ma buy a private island and just name it Coney. Ay, yeah, Coney. All my brothers roll deep. Ay, yeah, moving fast, all of you just low speed. I don't quit, I dust myself off and I keep on going. She asked me why I eat so good, girl, you taste like Coney's. Make me go speak in my soapbox. She's clean like she clove rocks. The way that she's, I'm changing her name. Peeping, poking my niggas be sleeping. Sleep on me harder than Snorlax. Until I drop, you say my nasty. Tell me it's nasty like coleslaw. My place is not vacant. Ain't no way that you can just replace me. She tell me she mine, but I know that she lying. I know that can't be taken. She be like, did you can save me? Can't be saving.